Okay, dear students, welcome to this session. And in the session, we are going to look into the decision tree, and also there are a problem. We will look into that particular problem, and also there is a one problem which is from your exercise. We will try to solve that problem. As we saw in the previous sections, decision tree is a very popular technique, and it is used for the classification. And we can use it for the multi-classification or a binary classification. What is binary classification? You have only two classes. For example, problem statement: a particular person is having a diabetic, having a diabetes, yes or no. A particular person having a heart-related disease, yes or no. Or particular person should be given with a loan, yes or no. Or particular person will be a defaulter, loan defaulter, yes or no. Those kinds of problems are called as a binary classification. And in case of a multi class problems, we will have multiple classes. One example is a news classification. You have news articles, you do the news mining, you mine all the news data, and you want to classify into multiple classes. Let's say sports, politics, entertainment, technology, science, research related. So those are the multi-classification problems, and both kinds of problems can be solved using the decision trees. And decision trees are nothing but a hierarchically branched structures that will have a simple questions. Based on the answer to the questions, it will take a particular branching, and there will be multiple nodes or multiple questions that you answer, and accordingly you will end up with a particular result or the answer or the class. And so that is how the structure of the decision tree. And if you see the decision trees, they mimic how the human decisions are made, how the experts will make the decisions. Suppose if you are consulting a doctor, or if you are consulting an advocate, or if you are consulting a any financial advisor. So it starts with a series of questions. So doctor will ask a very important questions, starting with a very important questions. Then he drill down his questions. Then he will conclude. Okay, this could be the possibility, and according to that he proposes the diagnosis. So that is how the decision trees, we can model it, and the ML algorithms, they will use this model, and we can use those models for real-time decision making systems. And the decision tree model, in order for to create that model, we need a training data. What is the meaning of the training data? Training data, already you have a historical data, and the each of the data points are classified. If it is a binary classification, one of the two classes, each data point will be given with one of the two data points. If it is a multi-class, multi-classes will be given, so that the that particular data can be used to train the model. Once the model gets trained on the training data, and if we are happy with the performance of the model, let us say it is more than 90% accurate, then we will have the test data. And test data is nothing but it is part of the same historical data that we keep. Certain part we keep it as a training data, certain part as a test data. Training data, let us say 80% or 70%, then test data would be either 20% or 30%. Then we test our model on that test data, and if we find a similar or better performance, like the 90% or 95% accuracy, then we will say this model is good for the production deployment, and we will put that into the production, and we will start using that particular model for making real-time decisions. So that real-time decisions would be like you give a unknown data, you give, so whatever the training set it has, whatever the test set it has, apart from that you give the unknown data, and it will classify and it will give the answer, and that answer would be based on your accuracy, let us say 90% accuracy. Out of 100 questions or out of 100 data points, accurately it will tell 90 correctly. That is the meaning of that. And this is the one example we saw for the people having a second heart attack within the 30 days of a diagnosis. And based on that, we got this particular model. And the success rate of that particular model is around 86.5%. Okay, so this is how the decision tree are formed. And the decision tree predictive accuracy, we talked about the accuracy of 90% or whatever the percentage, it depends on certain factors. One of the most important thing is the how much training data you have. If there is a huge amount of training data, then the model would be very, very accurate. And if the number of parameters or the variables, or you can also call them as a predictor variables. If number of predictor variables or the independent variables are more, then and those are very decisive in making the whatever the class, whatever the output we are going to get, then if we have more such variables, then it would be the accuracy will be also be very, very high. And in addition to this, we want to have the good decision tree should be very simple, right? It should use a reasonable amount of the questioning and reasonable amount of the branching. So that is a frugal structure. So just economic, whether it is the width of the tree, whether it is the depth of the tree, we don't want it to be very, very huge tree explaining every data element. So then what happens is it is called as a case of overfitting. And if we have very, very small tree, it is a case of an underfitting. We don't want overfitting or underfitting. We just want the optimal tree. And we are going to see a one decision tree problem, and where we will create the decision tree. And then we will ask this particular question. Okay. So we have a data, historical data, where we have the outlook is given, temperature is given, humidity is given, and windy or not, it is given. So based on that, we have to build a decision tree model, and we have to test that decision tree model, and we have to find the answer for this. So in this particular example, there are two ways of solving this problem. Either when I have the historical data, then I have a lookup table, right? I can use it as a lookup table, and then just I will, in the lookup table, I will compare whether outlook is sunny, hot, humidity is normal, if windy is true. If there is a particular value for the play, then directly I will display that. So that is my decision. That is from the lookup table. If I don't have that record, then I will not be able to predict. So that is the end of the lookup table. So that is why we need a decision tree which will go beyond the lookup tables. And also we saw some of the disadvantages regarding the lookup table. How to decide if there is a row is not present. So for a particular example, if the row is not present in the database, then we cannot give the answer. If the row is present, then 100%, yes, we can give very accurate answer. And second one is, the problem is, whenever we have any kind of a data points, we have to look through the complete database, you know, in order to find the answer for that. And there is a problem if the totally some variable is missing. Suppose, let us say, out of this one variable is missing, then lookup will straightforward, it will fail. It will not be able to give any kind of a results. Now we will construct a decision tree. With this example, we will see how to construct a decision tree and how to implement it. And then we will test the given problem. So given problem is, this we have to find an answer for that. If it is a sunny, temperature is hot, humidity normal, humidity is normal, windy is true, whether outdoor play should be allowed or not. That is the complete problem statement. Okay, approving the play of an outdoor game. So whether we should approve, yes or no. So that we will find out. First, we will try to understand the data. We have four variables. These are called as a independent variables, and this is the target or the dependent variable. We are going to predict this particular variable based on the input given by these four independent variables. And outlook has a values like a sunny, overcast, rainy, right? Those are the different values it has. Temperature, we have hot, cool, mild. And humidity, normal, high, And so those are the two values I have for the humidity. Windy, true or false, whether it is a windy, yes or no. Based on these values, the decision to play outside, that is play outdoor, either no or yes. So it is a binary classification, either yes or no. So based on this data, we have to construct a decision tree. First task is determining the root node of the tree. So you saw the earlier example. Okay. So this is the root node. How to decide upon how we are going to get this root node? So first we will check how to come up with the root node. In this example, there are four choices of questions based on the four variables. We have outlook, we have temperature, we have humidity, and we have the wind speed, right? These are the four factors. One of this could be probable candidate for the root element or the root node. Criteria should be used by which one of these questions gives the most insight about the situation. So one of this question, out of this, we will be selecting one question which will give a better insight into the decision making. So whether to play outside or not. The criteria of frugality is a good one. That is, which question will provide us a shortest ultimate tree. So that is the second way. It is a criteria of a frugality where we have a very simple structure. By choosing that, we get a very simple structure for the shortest tree. And another way to look at this is that if one is allowed to ask only one question, which one would they will ask? So let us say we tell only one question can be asked out of those, then you will choose the most important question, isn't it? So what is that most important question out of those four? The most important question should be one that by itself helps make most correct decisions with the fewest errors. So let us say I ask one question, it gets me the very correct answer, not 100%, almost correct answer. That would be the most important question. So we will start with any variable. In this case, it can be three values, sunny, overcast, and rainy. First, we will start with the outlook variable. So if you see the data, just remember this data. We start with the outlook and we follow some rule. Okay, we will say sunny and no. Okay, sunny and no. Okay, this is very accurate. Sunny and no, correct. Two second is also correct. Then I will use where is the next sunny? Okay, sunny, no. Okay, I got three sunny no that is matching. Then we have sunny yes. So here we get a false. Sunny yes. So out of five sunny values for the outlook, three are having a rule sunny no, and two are having sunny yes. Now if I have a outlook attribute is outlook, I have a rule called sunny and no. How many errors I will get? Sunny no, three out of five records, three are correct, right? Sunny no, there are three records. So if I use the rule, if it is sunny, the output should be no. If I say this as the rule, how many correct answers I will get? Three out of five correct answers. And how many error? Two out of five. So we saw there is two records which said sunny yes. So how much is the error? 2/5. 2/5 is the error. Next we will take overcast. Okay, let me go back to the data again. Okay, so or you can choose any rule. We will choose the rule which has a less error. So my intention is less error. You might ask me, why didn't I choose sunny yes? If I choose sunny yes, how many errors I will get? 3/5, right? Three out of the five are wrong. That's why I am choosing sunny no, where the error is less, 2/5. Now let us say I choose overcast yes. Let me go back to the data. Okay, overcast and answer yes, one record. Overcast yes, two record. Overcast yes, three record. Overcast yes, four records. So all the overcasts are done. There are four records. If I have a rule, if it is Outlook is overcast, then I would say play as S. If I choose this particular rule, I have zero errors. Overcast S, all the records, they followed that rule. If it is overcast, answer is S. And then what is the zero? Zero, what is the error? 0/4. Okay, there are no errors. So this is a clear-cut decision. If overcast is yes, then the play is play outdoor is yes. Similarly, we will do it for the other values. Now, next is rainy. So there are three possible values are there. Sunny we did, overcast we did, then rainy yes will take. I will go back to the data again. Now rainy yes, one record. Rainy yes, two records. Rainy no, third record. But the rule failed here. What the rule we have? Rainy yes, so it failed here. Then again we have one more record. Rainy yes, it worked here. Then one more record, rainy no. So if I have a rule, rainy yes, out of the five instances it is correct in three instances. So here it is correct, here it is correct, and one more is here it is correct, rainy and S. But two instances it is failed. So what is the error that I get if I choose rainy S? Two errors, means in two scenarios out of the five scenarios we will get answer as incorrect. Now we are done with all the possible rules. Now we will find the total error. So total error is what? It is not like a algebraic sum of these things. Okay, this is not an algebraic sum. Whatever is the denominator, it represents a total number of the records, and on the numerator it is total number of the records where the rule failed, means error. So what are the total number of records? Denominator 5 + 5, 10 + 4, 14. Out of the 14 instances or the records, this rules overall Outlook failed in 4 instances, that is 2 + 0 + 2, 4. So total error for the Outlook is 4/14. So this is we did for the Outlook first variable. Then what is the next variable we have? The next variable we have temperature, next one is humidity, next one is windy. Similarly, we will do it for the temperature. Okay, for temperature we have three possible values: hot, mild and cool. For temperature I will choose the rule hot and no. So I will go back to the data. Every time you have to go back to the data and check. For temperature I will choose hot, no. Hot, no, second record. Hot, yes, the rule failed. Then I have hot, yes, again rule failed. So if I choose a rule hot, no, it will be successful two times and it will fail two times. What is the error? The total error would be 2/4, that is 50% of the time it will fail. Similarly, I'm not going to do the analysis, we will not go back to the data. You can do it like looking at the data. If we choose a rule mild S, out of the 6 records which are having mild and some output, it will fail 2 times out of the 6, means there are 4 instances or the records where we have mild S, and we have 2 records which we have mild no. So mild no is a failure. We get an error 2 times out of the total 6 instances. And if we choose cool S rule, we get 1 out of the 4 rule will fail. What would be the total error that we get? 6 + 4, 10, 14. Out of the 14 instances, 5 times overall the temperature entity will fail. This is the total error, 5/14, which is more than the Outlook. Then similarly, I will choose the humidity. Humidity has two possibilities: high, no. This is the rule, high, no. Out of the 7 instances, it fails in 3 instances. So error is 3/7. And normal, yes. So normal, yes is a very good rule. Out of the 7, it fails only in 1 instance. Correct? So it will fail in only 1 instance. Total is 4/14, that is the total error in case of a humidity attribute, which is same as the outlook. Then last one is the windy, false, yes, there is an error of 2 times out of the 8 instances. True, no, there is a failure of 3 out of the 6 instances. Total error is 5 out of 14. Okay. So before I proceed, do you have any questions, guys? This is very, very important. In exams, simple such problems will be asked. You can score 100% marks if you have a clear understanding. Any questions?
No, sir.
All right. Okay. Once you have the first level you have done, then you have two choices here. I have 4 by 14 and 4 by 14. Two errors are there. Okay. Two possibilities of the root node I can have. One is the outlook and one is the humidity. Which one to select among these two? So when we have the same error, then we go for the purity. Okay. What is the purity? Purity is like, if you see here, I have a rule here, overcast, yes, means there are no errors, absolutely no errors. We do not have any such pure answers here, or the purity is not available. But we have a purity of answer here. If I say overcast, definitely it is the answer is the yes. Play outdoor is yes. So when we have the same error, minimum error, when we have a choice between the two minimum errors, we have to go for a variable or the attribute which gets a pure node. So this is a pure node. So that's why we are going to select the outlook. So I will select. So this is how we made the decision to select the root node as outlook. Once I have outlook as the root node, what are the possible values I have for outlook? The possible values are sunny, overcast and rain. Okay, if it is sunny, okay, the first one is sunny, and second one is, if it is overcast, the answer is yes. Already we got the output outdoor, it will directly give the output. If it is overcast, the answer is yes. And second possibility, third possibility is rainy. Now I am going to choose the table, whatever the records, which has outlook as sunny. Okay, so you can see that particular table where outlook is sunny. If you want to put it in a DBMS SQL, so that table, select star from that table where outlook is equal to sunny. Whatever records you get, you are going to write it here. I will go back to the main table and I will explain how we got, how many records are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you remember we are not considering the outlook here. Outlook is already decided as sunny. We are going to take the rest of the three variables, temperature, humidity and windy, and the output, that is the output variable or the dependent variable or the target variable play. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 records. Let me go back to the main table and I will select outlook as sunny, and whatever the records we get, we will see. Now outlook is sunny. How many records are here? I have with outlook as sunny 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I am going to select these 5 records, but I am not going to select outlook. So rest of the values I will take: hot, high, false, no, hot, high, true, false, true, no. So these 1, 2 records, and again I am going to take mild, high, false, no, and again one more record: cool, normal, false, yes. This is the record. Then sunny, mild, normal, true, yes. So I am going to select these two, means temperature, humidity, windy and play only, these two records. Then these two records, two hot, okay, one mild, one cool, and one mild. So total I have two hot, two mild and one cool. That is what I get here. So two hot, mild, cool and mild. This is the record set, and this is incorrect, it should be yes. Okay, just I have corrected. Similarly, on the other hand, other side, on the rainy branch, whatever is outlook is rainy, I'm going to select those records. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. three mild and two cool are there. I will show you in the main table. Outlook is rainy. I have these two records, mild, cool, and one more record, rainy, cool, three records. This is mild, okay, then mild. So these five records I am going to select on that particular branch. Now I know the data on the sunny side, data on the rainy side. Now I am going to apply the same rule what I did earlier. Out of these three, which one is the most important question I can ask, where the error is less, so that it will get me a pure answer for the play. Similarly, on this side, out of these three variables, what kind of a question or what kind of a rule I can put, which will get me a minimum error, that particular variable I am going to choose it as a child node. Okay, first we will focus on this side, sunny side. Go to the next side. So this is the sunny side. On sunny side, so I will select the temperature first. So temperature first, I have hot, hot, two hots are there, two milds are there, one cool is there. For hot, I will say hot, no, hot, no. Perfect answer, right? If I choose a rule, hot, no, zero errors, two instances, it is correct. Then next is mild. I will select mild, no, mild, yes. So if I choose a rule called mild, no, it will fail in one of the two instances. So what is the error? 1/2. And cool, yes. If I choose cool, yes, this is correct, zero error. Now what is the these are the individual errors for the temperature. Out of five instances, okay, out of five instances I get one error, that is 1/5 is the total error. Then similarly for the humidity, humidity I have high, high, no. If I select high, no, okay, high, no, high, no, so zero error again. You can see high, no, 0/3. If I select normal, S, normal, S, normal, S, so this is a perfect node. Okay, 0/3 error, 0/2 error. The total error by selecting humidity is zero. So I will get a very clear next branch. So I will continue with the analysis. Next, windy, false, no. Go back, windy, false, no, false, no, false, yes. It failed in one instance. So one out of the three, it failure. Then I use a true S rule on the windy. Windy, true S failure, true S success. So there is a one failure, that is 50% failure. One of the two failed. Total error, 2 out of 5. Now, if you consider this, the straightforward choice is what? Humidity. We can select next node as humidity, where we will ask the, like, what is the humidity? Humidity, yes, it will be, humidity is high, then the play is no. If humidity is normal, the play is yes. So before, this is on the sunny side, we completed. Let us move on to the rainy side. Similarly, on the rainy side, I will do the same analysis. Temperature, mild, S, 1 out of 3. I will just go back two slides. On this side, temperature, mild, S, success, mild, S, success, mild, S, failure. So it failed 1 out of 3 times. So mild, S, it failed 1 out of 3 times. If I use the rule cool, S, go back, cool, S, success, cool, no, failure. So it failed 1 out of 2 instances. Write down 1 out of 2 instances. So that is the complete records. So total error, 2/5, means 2 times this temperature rule fails out of the 5 instances. Then humidity, high, no. Humidity, high, yes, failure, high, no, success. So the failure rate is, error is 1/2. Error is 1/2. Normal, S, if I select normal, S, success, normal, S, failure, normal, S, success. So 1/3 is the error. Normal, S, 1 out of 3 is a error, and total error is 2 out of 5. Then windy. Now, windy, false, yes, success, false, yes, success, false, yes, success. So 0 out of the 3 means error is 0. Similarly, if I select the rule true, no, success, true, no, success. So we have very clear cut attribute which will result into true or false classes. So if windy is false, the play is yes. If windy is true, the false play is no. So this is the error is 0/5. In case of a sunny side, we got humidity having 0/5 error. On the rainy side, we got windy as a 0/5 error. So now we will be able to construct the further decision tree. So we had decision tree until here. On this side, we had sunny. On this side, we had rainy. And on this data, we did similar analysis. Which question, important question can be asked? The question that can be asked is on the humidity, which got a less. If humidity is high, the play is no. If humidity is normal, the play is yes. And overcast, we already got on the first iteration itself. On the other side, if outlook is rainy, then we are going to ask the question whether it is a windy. If it is a true, no. If it is false, it is yes. So this is our model. So we are ready with our model. Now we will go back to the original question. What was the original question we had? This is the unknown set, right? This unknown set, I will apply this particular model on this unknown set and I will get the answer whether playing outside is allowed or not. So outlook sunny, outlook sunny. So I will come on this branch. Then I have to check humidity. Humidity is normal. So humidity is normal in just two questions, right? This is one question, this is second question. We came to the answer yes, means outdoor play is yes. This answer is going to be yes. Here you can see we did not ask the question about the temperature or the whether it's windy or not, because it branched out. So when we are having n number of variables, we can have based on our analysis, there might be certain variables that may not be required. Okay, we can have a very smaller decision trees based on what kind of a questions we ask. So if you ask the most important questions, then it will exclusively, it will make a two data sets, right? It will, our questions should be such that it should clearly divide the data into two parts so that we can further dig into the divided data. So this is the comparison with the lookup table. So lookup table accuracy in case of a lookup table is 100%. The reason being, if that particular record is available in the historical data, it will give the answer. If it is not there, it will not give the answer. That is why it is accurate. Okay, but we cannot consider it as accurate, because if we present with the unknown data set, right? Then it will not give the answer. Then we can, whether it is 100% or not, we will not be able to say. And decision trees, it can vary. I told you, based on the amount of the training data, how you structure your decision tree, its accuracy will depend. But normally we use the decision tree which are having a very high accuracy, maybe like very close to 90%, more than 90%, then only the are used in the production. Generality, general applies to all situations. Decision trees are very general. Whatever the kind of a questions you ask, it will be applied onto the model and it will give the answer. It is not specific to any like equations, like a lookup. It's going to compare all the columns and then it will give the result. But in case of a lookup table, applies only when similar case had occurred earlier. Otherwise, it will not give the answer. Frugality, only three variables are needed. We saw the previous example. Even though we have temperature, this was not used in anywhere of the decision tree. So that is how it is like a very frugal. All four variables are required if we want to have the lookup table. Simplicity, only one or maximum two variables values are needed. In case of lookup table, we need all the four values. And decision tree is very, very logical and easy to understand. From here structure, you can see, okay, outlook, if it is sunny, based on the humidity, whether it is if it is a high humidity, it is not allowed. If it is a normal humidity, it is accepted. On the other hand, if it is just a rainy and if it is not windy, if it is just raining, outdoor is okay. If it is raining as well as it is windy, it is not favorable to go for the outdoor play. And if it is overcast, no questions asked, you can go for the outdoor play. This is the decision tree algorithm. This is the general pseudo code that is given for the creating a decision tree. First, we have to create the root node and assign all the training data to it. So whatever the complete data that is given, we are going to assign it to the root node. And we have multiple variables. Based on the variable, we are going to select each of the variables and we are going to apply the rule. And whichever gives us the least error, that is how we are going to split the next nodes. Select the best splitting attribute according to certain criteria. Then add a branch node to the root node for each value of the split. So we are going to add the branch for the each value split. For initially, we did this. Outlook is the one we got, and we splitted the data. Whatever the overall data we had at the root node, we splitted that data into three. Okay, one is the sunny, one is the rainy, and one is the overcast. And that split data, again we did the analysis. So that is how we are going to do that repetition on that split data. Again, we are going to find the which is the node which will result in the which is the variable which will result in the minimum error. We are going to select, and that is how we are going to branch out. So that algorithm is this algorithm. These steps are continuously done until we have reached the stopping criteria. And stopping criteria, there are many ways to have the stopping criteria. One is like you reach the leaf node. What happened in our case? That is the end of the tree. Or if it is a very huge tree, then we have to see a certain depth. You should not go for the very too depth. Then it will become like the model will be overfitting, and the kind of results you get are not very accurate. And what is the splitting criteria? The variables can be chosen based on the different criteria, such as least error. That is what we did. Whichever was giving the least error, we chose those variables. Or there are other mechanisms to do that. So there are certain things called as a information gain or Gini's entropy. So those are the different metrics that we can use so that we can find the splitting criteria. And for binary values, two values will be used to split. For continuous variables such as age, BP, etc., range can be used to make a bins. Whenever we are splitting any values, if it is a continuous variable, what is a continuous variable? Which has a continuous value. For example, we have age, right? Age can have a continuous value from 1 to 100 plus, right? And the BP is a continuous value. If we have such values, then we have to bin it. We talked in the previous class, we have to divide it into different bins or different ranges. For example, age 1 to 18, then 19 to 30 and so on, and BP certain ranges. Then we can branch into those branches. Suppose our age gets into a branch of 1 to 18 age group or 19 to 30 age group, then that is how it will be carried out in the decision tree. And if it is a binary variable, there is no problem. Either it will go in yes or no kind of a values we will be having. So either it will move in a yes or it will move in the no direction. And number of branches at each node depends on the variable type, whether it is a binary or whether it is a continuous. If it is a binary variable, definitely we will have only two branches. If it is a continuous variable, depending upon how many ranges or the groups or the bins you have, those many branches you will have. For example, Outlook. So Outlook is here in the example. Outlook, we have categorized into sunny and overcast and rainy, right? So that is a three different branches. If you see here, humidity, again it is classified into high or normal, windy. So that windy, when we say windy, we have to cut off at some speed, right? It's a continuous variable. At what speed you will say it is windy, and at what speed you will say it is not windy. So that is defined into two categories, true and false. So that is how we are going to treat each of the continuous and the binary variables. Stopping criteria, as I told you, when certain depth of the branch has been reached, we don't want to have very too deep decision trees. They tend to become overfit. Okay, overfit the model and less accurate. So at certain depth, we want to stop, right? Or that could be based on a error at any node below a tolerable level. You will be checking the error at each of the node, and you will put some threshold. If it is below that threshold, if the error is below that threshold, then you will stop branching. So that is the stopping criteria we have to use. So we have to use some kind of a mechanisms to stop from decision tree growing without any control. So whether it is a width of the tree, whether it is the depth, it has to be like trimmed. So there are many pruning techniques also there, by using which we can prune the branches and keep our decision tree model at a very optimum level. These are the popular decision tree algorithms we have. We have C4.5, CART, and CHAID, and this is the comparative study of that. Full name, C4.5, it is a iterative dichotomizer, ID3 it is called. CART is a classification and regression trees. CHAID, chi square or a chi square, automatic interaction detector. Then basic algorithms use is Hund's algorithm in C4.5 and CART, and adjusted significance testing in case of a CHAID. Developer Ross Quinlan, C4.5. Then Bremen for the CART, Gordon, Cass for the CHAID. These are the year when they were developed. Types of trees, this is for the classification, classification and regression. For regression also we can use it. CART and the CHAID is for can be used for classification as well as the regression problem. C4.5 is for the classification. Then serial implementation, tree growth and tree pruning, tree growth and tree pruning, all of them uses the tree growth and tree pruning. Type of data, where we can have a discrete data, continuous, okay, incomplete data, similar to others. Types of splits, multi-way splits. Here we have binary splits only. Clever surrogate splits to reduce the tree depth. So basically these techniques are used to control the depth of the tree so that it doesn't overfit. Then in case of a CHAID, multi-way splits as default. Splitting criteria, okay, information gain, here gene is coefficient and others, here it is a chi-square test. Pruning criteria, clever bottom-up technique, avoids overfitting. Remove weakest links first, then trees can become very large in case of a CHAID. Implementation, publicly available, all these are, these two are publicly available, C4.5 and CART. And popular in market research for segmentation, that is the CHAID algorithm. This is one more example I have. This particular example, this is from the unsolved question that is in Anil Maheshwari book. You can try to solve this one. This is the data that is given, and this is the question that has to you have to solve. This is the data. Then solve the following problem using the model. Age young, job false, and house false, credit false. Basically, this is the young age that is bracketed into, that is grouped into three categories, young, middle, and old. Job true false, either has a job or no job. House, they have a house or no house, means own house. Then credit history, it is divided into three groups, fair, good, and excellent, and loan approved, whether yes or no, two values. If I have a scenario where age is young, the job is means no job and no house, and he has he or she has a good credit card, whether the answer would be yes or no, that is what you have to find out. I have 5 more minutes. Just quickly, I have solved this problem. And I will also share that solution with you guys. That PDF I'm going to share. And there are similar, one more problem is there that you can attempt. Okay, this is the problem, and data set is this is the data set. This is the data set. How we are going to approach? First, we have to come up with the root node. For root node, I have 4 options: age, job, house, and credit. Which one of these would be like important question, which will have a very minimum error and it will give me an answer? Probably, like if you go by intuition, maybe like age, or maybe the credit history, okay? And then you will feel maybe next important is the job. So let us see, based on the data, we apply the first age, okay? For the age, I can have rule young, no, okay? Young, no, right? Young, no, right? Young, yes, failed. Young, yes, failed. Young, no. So if I use a young, no rule, it will fail 2 times. So what is the error? 2/5. Error is 2/5. Middle S. If I say middle S, middle no failed, middle no failed, and next 3 are correct. So it failed in 2 cases. Again, middle S is, it will, error is 2/5. Old S. Okay. Old S. You can see 4 times it is correct, once it will fail. So error is 1/5. What is the total error? 2 + 2 + 1, that is 5/15. Similarly, next criteria, job. Job, I have false. First rule is false, no. False, no. False, no, 2 time correct. False, no, 3 time correct. False, no, 4 time correct. False, no, 5 time correct. Then false, yes, failed. False, yes, failed. False, yes, failed. False, yes, failed. False, no, correct. So I didn't count, but here I have, out of the 10 instances, 4 times this rule will fail. 6 times it is correct, means false no is 6 times it is correct, but it fails 4 out of the 10 instances. True yes. If you have a job, if you have a job, yes. So you can see true yes. In all the scenario, it is yes, 0 error. This resulted in 0 error. So 4 total error, 4/15. Then next is we have house. No, no. If you don't have a house, then no. You will get no, no rule, 3/9 error. If you select yes, yes. If you have a house, then loan approved is yes. So all the 6 times it is yes. So error is 0. Total error is 3/15. And next one is we have credit, fair no, good, fair no means it will, error is 1, fair yes is 1 error, fair no, fair no, again fair no, one more fair no. So we have this rule will succeed in 4 times out of the 5, so error is 1/5. Good S means if credit rate is good, so 4 times this rule will pass out of the 6 times. Error is 2/6. Excellent. Yes, 0/4. Now, what is the total error? We get here 3/15. Now, you can see clearly this is 5/15, 4/15. This is, will not consider that. What we can consider is 3/15 and 3/15. Now, you have 2 choices here. Either you can go with this, or you can go with this. It is up to the because both has a pure node. We have the purity here, if you want to go in this, you can go here. Just to be curious, this looks more lucrative because there are only 2 paths. What we are left with, only 3 errors. okay, but I have chosen this because by intuition, I told you, whenever you are working on data science project, intuition is very important. Okay, for me, like giving a credit or a loan to somebody, credit history is the most important factor. Okay, with that in mind, I have taken the last one. You can try with house this as a root node. You will get a different structure. Relatively, it should give the same answer. Now I have selected credit. So credit, fair, good, and excellent. If excellent, it is answer is like yes. So the loan will be approved. Then we go for the further. In fair and good, I am going to redistribute the data. Redistribute the data wherever the credit is fair. I am going to check the next three variables. Now I have selected the credit. Wherever it is fair, I am going to select age, job, and house, and I will frame a next question here. And wherever the credit is good, I will get the data. Okay, that particular data. And I will check which question would be good among the three. And excellent is already, the answer is yes. Loan approved is yes. And if I do that analysis, here I have done on the both the sides. This is for the fair and this is for the good. For the age, you can just do it. You will get 1/5 error. Job, 0/5. House, 0/5. Here for the good, this rule will get me. For the age, it will get me 1/6. For job, it will get me 1/6. And for house, it will get me 2/6. On the fair side of the branch, I can select either any of this, job or house, because both are very pure. Like any one, that is the end of the branching. Then on the good side, probably like again, I have two options here. 1/6, 1/6, age and job, two options are there. You can pick any one among them, like both are having the same kind of error, so any one can be picked. So whatever is my choice here, on this side I have picked job. Okay, job is picked. Fair, then job. Job false, no. Job true, yes. And on the good side, on the good side, I have chosen age. Here on the good side, good side, I have chosen the question age, young, my young, mid age, and the old. Okay, so young, age, this is young, no, middle age, no, and old age, yes. So that is the, now the answer to our question, that is this question. What is the question? Age young, okay, job false, house false, credit good. So I start with a credit good, it will come here, credit good. Then I'm going for a age young, credit good, age young, answer is no. So loan approved, no. So you can try for this option. You can take root node, you take the different root node. As I told you, there are two options, credit or house. You can pick house and you see how that structure would be, whether you get a simpler structure than this or more complex structure than this. If it is more simpler, you can use that. So this is how the modeling is. We are going to iterate through different models. We put it into the test and then we select the best model.